Hey, Dave Fan here with Body Form Personal Training Fitness Boot Camps. Question Dave, I'm worried about my spouse getting fatter and dying early. What do I do? Very common question, probably in the top three, next to, you know, how do I show up to work out and what should I eat to lose weight? Those are the top two. And this is probably number three. At least every week when I sit down with a girl, she'll say, yeah, my husband needs this. He's really out of shape. What do I do? And so we'll answer that question today because it's easy to laugh at some of these problems, but the seriousness of the outcome, and it does rub people wrong sometimes. But the reality is the outcomes of not exercising and not taking care of yourself are so bad, we have to kind of like look at it in the face sometimes. So when you're looking at a spouse who doesn't work out, when my girls come in and they start working out, for the gentleman not working out over time, three things happen. As they move towards their 30s, 40s, and 50s, they're overweight and out of shape. They become a little bit more lethargic, lazy, and they slow down. And girls don't like seeing their guys slow down. Number two, they're dicky do, dicky don't. All kinds of problems happen with gentlemen who are overweight, especially through the midsection, where you see a guy carrying a lot of weight through the midsection. Number one is impotence begins, and then you have all kinds of problems within the relationship, and that's not good for anybody. And then the third thing is, a lot of my ladies come in and they sign up, and I go, well, you know, what brought you in here? And they'll say, well, I took care of my husband for the last 3, 5, 10 years, as he went through a long disease process and then passed away. And I'm ready to get back out there and meet somebody new. So the long, slow, where they're getting diabetes, heart problems, and then you, as the wife, end up having to take care of him for 3, 5, 10 years as his health deteriorates. And the excellent news is exercise and a very basic, healthy diet can prevent 80% of disease and accidents after the age of 50. There's all kinds of benefits. And for men, when you want to bring in the wife, three things. When girls are overweight and out of shape in their 20s, 30s, they have problems conceiving. And if you want to see a girl that's unhappy, tell her she can't have a baby or she's going to struggle getting pregnant. So doctors generally now want you at a good weight and exercising before you start that process. Number two, anecdotally, girls come in their 40s and late 50s and they say, well, when I turned about 38, 40, I kind of started slowing down and I felt so bad. I started doing even less because everything I used to do didn't work anymore. And now I've got a 30 or 40 pounds extra on me. And if you want to see a girl that's unhappy, add 30 pounds. She's going to be really unhappy and they had no energy. And then the third thing is menopause. A lot of ladies come in and you have to keep moving. Exercise and a basic diet, and we're not talking about 5-10 times a week of exercise, but a basic 3 times a week, 30 minutes sessions, offsets about 80% of problems with menopause. And so for gentlemen, bringing the wife in, all kinds of benefits. So there's no downside. And what's interesting and instructive is that you exercising has the greatest impact on will your spouse exercise. John Hopkins just did a study, took about 6 years, took about 3,500 people in their 40s and 50s, and they used it through their physicians. They took these 3,500 people, and when they came in on their first visit, they said, do you exercise? Does your spouse exercise? And what they found was over a 6-year period for women who had a steady exercise program, who's on the first questionnaire, the husband did not exercise. 6 years later, 70% of the husbands had picked up the exercise habit. That is significant. By you consistently showing up and exercising, the husbands picked up the habit too. For men who were exercising and the wife was not exercising, 6 years later, 40% had picked up the exercise habit, a significant amount. It goes to show The number one thing you can do to influence your spouse to exercise is for you to lead the way by example and all kinds of benefits. You can, this is what I always tell people, especially when we have like a referral program, drag them along. You gotta drag them. Most people don't wanna change what they're doing, but in the beginning, you have to drag them along, kicking and screaming sometimes for their own good. It's not much different than a toddler, you know? And that's the way you have to look at it. Drag them in there. One or two sessions, they feel so much damn better than they have for the last 10 or 20 years. And they go, shit, maybe I should show up the rest of my life. And that's how you do it. You show up, you keep showing up, you lead by example, and those people that are around you that you care about will follow your example over time. That's the most important thing. And the interesting thing is, too, that they looked at this, and if the spouse stopped working out, the other spouse stopped working out, too. You have a major influence, and you have a major impact on how your life is going to evolve over the next 20 or 30 years, and your spouse's. Help them lose weight, feel better, you're active, all kinds of benefits, better relationships. You just feel better. There's no downside. The number one thing that you can do to make sure that your spouse does not keep gaining weight and does pick up the exercise and eating better habit is to lead by example, showing up 2 to 3 times per week, 30-minute sessions. You don't have to be an athlete. You don't have to run a marathon. Just 3 sessions a week, 30 minutes over time, all kinds of benefits. That's the number one thing you can do. And then you just drag them. I use that word all the time. Drag them with you. Make them do it. In the beginning, they may start kicking and screaming, but you know what? I've never had somebody go, you know what? This exercise thing, I wish I'd never started. It was a terrible idea. I wish I kept smoking and drinking and died early. That's not going to happen. No one has ever said that, and they won't say it to you. When you drag them in, keep showing up and get the results that you're looking for, and then bring your spouse, and they'll get the results they're looking for, and they'll feel better, better relationships. There's no downside. Everybody wins at the end of the day. If you like this video, like it, share it, comment below. I'm Dave Fannin with the Body Form Personal Training Fitness Bootcamps. Hope you guys have a great day.